I'm here with Alex Salmond, First Minister, who has just made his major conference speech to a huge accolade. First Minister, how are you feeling after that speech?
Well, I'm just worried a bit nervous, Bill Holmes.
I mean, the party's in great mood, you know. Not just, I think, about the election victory, but about the performance of the government, about the new MSPs elected, the fact that we've got a mandate and we're closer to our objective of Scottish independence than we've ever been before. Now, you know, this is a hard-working party. They'll take nothing for granted. They work harder than any other party in Scotland. They'll keep doing that.
You seem to be, well, indicating gently that there was the possibility that we might, in fact, see two questions running on the referendum. How do you feel about that? Do you really have the party support for that?
Yes, I'm sure I have. I mean, that's what I said in the election. I mean, we'll have a yes-no question to independence. We'll have a white paper explaining our belief in independence, and we'll ask people to say yes or no to it. But I'm not for foreclosing options for the Scottish people, and I think it's perfectly legitimate to ask a question about fiscal autonomy as well. Again, a yes-no question. Remember, in 1997, Scotland was asked two questions. It was asked in the first devolution referendum. The vote was for yes, if you remember. Yeah. So it's perfectly reasonable not to close the options open to the Scottish people. Now, the reason I can't be definite about it is not for any other reason than that option has to be put forward, that has to be enunciated. The SNP are for the independence option. And if a group of people, perhaps, who knows, I mean, in the last few weeks, Henry McLeish, one of my predecessors, was coming out in favour of that option. A group of people, or parties, have to put forward that option. I can't do it for them. You know, the government can facilitate the referendum, but we can't put forward an option. Our job is to put forward the independence option so as the people of Scotland get the opportunity to vote for that. But you know, the contrast between us and Westminster, I mean, we've got a mandate to consult the people in a consultative referendum, as all referendums have to be. They don't have a mandate to either stop it or to do it. We've got the mandate, and they have to understand that these days, the dark days of Westminster, telling Scotland what to do, what to think, these days are over now.
It's interesting that you should say that just when the news is so full of this story that David Cameron may want to create some sort of partnership with Scottish Labour and, as it were, take off the referendum, bring it back to Westminster. What do you think of that idea?
Well, of course, there's mass confusion. I mean, Downing Street immediately rubbished the story. It came out on the same day as William Hague was saying we couldn't have a referendum in Europe because of the economic situation. They're all over the place. I mean, sixes and sevens does not describe the confusion in the hearts of the establishment at Westminster at the present moment. But no, I mean, he'd be very foolish to go back on what he said. He said that he recognised the mandate after the election. He recognised this was a matter for the Parliament of Scotland. And if he goes back in that, then it will be the greatest single political mistake of his career. And he's made one or two already.
Are they 40?
Yeah, I think, listen, the day that David Cameron actually does something positive for Scotland will be the day I believe that he's ever experienced too much of the Scots language.
Thank you very much, First Minister.
Great pleasure.
Let's get on the ball, that we're together. Come on.